You're tuning into Black and White Sports on YouTube. The no holds barred truth on sports. The main event starts now.
I'm back. Rodriance for Black and White Sports. We continue to get further information coming in about the woke implosion over at the Disney-owned, yeah, that Disney, the one that continuously virtue signals, the one that continuously destroys certain products that have come out, causing them to lose money. Remember, they got raked over the coals during an investor call not too long ago over Gina Carano. An investor literally called them out on a call. Well, Disney-owned ESPN has been in the midst of a massive meltdown the last week, stemming from leaked audio that came out from Rachel Nichols in a private conversation, by the way. And Maria Taylor, one of their analysts, got all up in arms because Rachel Nichols said that Maria Taylor got handed the NBA Finals job in the bubble because Maria Taylor was black in wake of the rise of the BLM and the death of George Floyd. Well, a lot of things have come out that's made ESPN look even worse. Mind you, this is a company that destroyed itself and its business model over the last 4 or 5 years, trying to virtue signal, trying to please everybody with identity politics, and oh my goodness, it has all backfired. Now we're getting backstories, including one, something that was said about my favorite ESPN SportsCenter host, favorite ESPN personality they ever had was Stuart Scott. And I find this, I find what was said about Stuart to be offensive. And this time it comes by way of former, very well-known ESPN anchor Mike Hill. Now, Mike Hill's left ESPN, went to FS1, and is now hosting something called the Black News Channel. I don't know what that is. I can't figure out why we would need to segregate a news channel based on skin color. But I don't know what's going on there. But he has come out and said some things about ESPN executives. And wow, some things that were said about not only himself, but in describing Stuart Scott. And I think it's awful. Very quickly, I am wearing our ESPCNN shirt. That's right, the worldwide leader in woke. This is an old school, an oldie but goodie, as we like to call it. 2 days, the rest of the weekend, promo code ESPCNN will get you 25% off this shirt or any other shirt in the merch store. Go grab one now. Okay, Mike Hill, yikes. This is crazy. Mike Hill says he was told he was, quote, too ghetto for promotion at ESPN. The former sports anchor opened up about his past at the network when discussing the current controversy surrounding Maria Taylor and Rachel Nichols. Mike Hill has opened up about his past at ESPN in a recent television appearance. He shared that the culture was, quote, different there, and detailed a story in which he was told he was, quote, too ghetto to get a promotion. Wow. ESPN has been in the headlines lately about an intense controversy surrounding sports journalist Maria Taylor. We just went over that. Rachel Nichols, ESPN NBA correspondent, the host of The Jump, who is white, was heard on a 2020 Hot Mic video made public this year, insinuating that ESPN was giving Taylor a plum assignment to improve their diversity agenda. Wow. You go woke, you go broke. Taylor broke her silence on social media earlier this week, writing that though she has taken some punches, she is, quote, still in the fight. Now other former employees are calling out the network for their workplace culture, including Mike Hill. There's Mike Hill. We all know Mike Hill. We've seen him host SportsCenter a million times. On the Black News Channel, Hill said it was suggested that he was, quote, too ghetto to get a promotion at the esteemed network. He explained, I did work there 9 years. And it's sad, when I worked there, there was a certain culture that existed at ESPN. Look, I will give them credit for being the worldwide leader. I probably wouldn't be in the position I am today if it wasn't for those four letters being on my resume. He continued, at the time, I did realize that I did experience a culture at ESPN that maybe exists in other places. The sad thing about ESPN is it can be such a great utopia, but at times it isn't. A lot of times the accountability factor is select accountability. Uh-oh. There are times where I would do things or I would say things and I would get in trouble for it. My colleagues who didn't look at me would say things and they would be praised for it, he shared. There has not been one black person that has been on air that I can think of did not go through hell at ESPN. Wow. He continued, when I was there, I was told in a meeting with a talent executive that said, quote, the reason you're not moving up at ESPN is because you're too ghetto. This from an executive, a talent executive there, an old white man. Wow. He'll then list an array of black talent who has gone through the network, including the late Stuart Scott, Stephen A. Smith, Jemele Hill, and more. He says Scott, who was known for his popular phrases like booyah, and let's not forget, cool as the other side of the pillow, and others, was deemed the resident, quote, ghetto anchor. Fuck you, ESPN. According to Hill, anybody that has gone through there has been some sense that you have gone through some sort of hell at ESPN. I'll just put it that way. It needs to change. Comparing ESPN and how ABC, quote, cleaned up their culture, both networks share Disney as a parent company, Hill detailed his journey since leaving the sports network. People are going to look at me and say, you know what, Mike, you're just bitter. I left ESPN 8 years ago and I moved on. Okay, so that was the end of the article. So, regardless of how you feel, and I'll be quite frank with you, I'm pretty sure that Mike Hill is pretty damn woke himself. Okay, if I remember correctly, last year, he said some things that, look, were just complete lunacy. But I also don't believe any workplace should be referring in that manner to people that has a resume like Stuart Scott, okay? I mean, look, Stuart Scott is what? One of the top five guys they've ever had at ESPN? Remember, before Keith Olbermann lost his ever-loving mind, it was Dan Patrick, Keith Olbermann. And when they transferred over and they went out of the company, it became Rich Eisen and Stuart Scott. And for them to refer to Stuart Scott in that manner, the resident ghetto dude, the resident ghetto anchor, this makes ESPN look pathetic. It looks pathetic. And that also tells you that out in public, all of that woke persona they had been carrying on, guess what? Hypocrisy. Does it surprise us? No. Hypocrisy behind closed doors. Disney, ESPN, were saying and doing things that doesn't look too flattering right now. I think this is, look, there is absolutely no, number one, Mike Hill, sorry, but there's no excuse for a black news network. What the hell is going on there? News should be for everybody and should be honest news. But I'm never in a million years going to condone any behavior where somebody is referred to in that manner. I can tell you, long before corporate America, when I worked in it, you certainly better not refer to anybody of any skin color as being, quote, ghetto. I can tell you right now, that's not going to be looked upon too fondly, okay? And I'm in rural Texas, and that's been a while since I worked corporate America. But I'm just saying, you have to be a little bit more professional in your work environment, and now we're finding out that ESPN has been full of crap. They have been full of crap this entire time with all their identity politics, all their virtue signaling. They were full of it. Tell me what you think, Black and White sports fans. ESPN has been exposed here. Honestly, it's pretty funny to see the house burning down right now. Peace. I'm out. Till next time.
Thanks for watching the show. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Be sure to tune in next time on Black and White Sports.